Welcome to the mock test series of AIIMS Rishikesh 2019 Nursing Officer Exam Part 1 video, which contains 50 questions. This is Satu Carry Online Nursing Channel. I am Satish Rajamani. Nursing is my profession, teaching is my passion. In this video, we are going to discuss 50 expected questions for Nursing Officer Exam of AIIMS Rishikesh 2019. Before going to today's video, please subscribe to Satu Carry Online Nursing Channel if you have not yet subscribed. Let's see the first question of the day. Human diseases are due to bad clothes was a part of which theory? Option A, supernatural causes theory. B, miasma theory. C, germ theory. D, epidemiological triad. The right answer is Option B, miasma theory. Question number 2. Which of the following dimensions is not included in the World Health Organization definition of health? Option A, physical well-being. B, occupational well-being. C, mental well-being. And D, social well-being. The right answer is Option B, occupational well-being is not included in the WHO definition of health. Question number 3. The systematic study of the means by which biomedical and other relevant knowledge is brought to bear on the health of individuals and communities under a given set of conditions is the definition given to Option A, biomedical research. B, health system research. C, intersectoral research. And D, operations research. The correct answer is Option B, health systems research. Question number 4. The term disease control employs all of the following except Option A, reducing the complications. B, reducing the risk of further transmission. C, reducing the incidence of disease. D, reducing the prevalence of disease. The right answer, Option D, reducing the prevalence of disease, is known as disease control. Question number 5. Choose the correct sequence in order of occurrence. Option A, disease, disability, impairment, handicap. Option B, disease, impairment, handicap, disability. C, handicap, disease, impairment, disability. D, disease, impairment, disability, handicap. Choose the correct sequence in an order. The correct sequence is disease, impairment, disability and handicap. Question number 6. If a physician orders a nurse to do oral as well as nasal suction to a client, which suction you will do first? Option A, oral. B, nasal. C, where there is less secretion. And D, where there is more secretion. So here the right answer is Option A, oral suction should be done first by a nurse for a patient, followed by the nasal secretion, nasal suction will be carried on. Question number 7. Which of the following is not sterilized by antiseptic solution? Option A, suction catheter. B, enema tube. C, surgical scissor. D, nasogastric tube. Which of the following is not sterilized by antiseptic solution? The right answer is Option C, surgical scissor. Question number 8. The management option for primary mother with right occipito posterior position in second stage of labor is Option A, immediate cesarean section. B, forceps application. C, watchful expectancy. D, breech extraction. The management option for primary mother with right occipito posterior position in second stage of labor. The right answer is option B, forceps application. Question number 9. Varicella vaccine is option A, killed, B, live attenuated vaccine, B, purified antigen, and D, toxoid. The right answer, varicella vaccine is live attenuated vaccine. Question number 10. Vagotomy is a surgical treatment for option A, nerve disorder, B, peptic ulcer, C, regurgitation, and D, hepatitis. The right answer, vagotomy is a surgical treatment for peptic ulcer disease. Question number 11. Select the prodrug from the following. Option A, enalapril, B, dopamine, C, nitroglycerin, D, aspirin. Select the prodrug. The right answer is enalapril is a prodrug. 12. Major mechanism of transport of drugs across biological membrane is option A, passive diffusion, B, facilitated diffusion, C, active transport mechanism, D, endocytosis. Major mechanism of transport of drugs across biological membrane is known as option A, passive diffusion. Question number 13. Match the set 1 with set 2. Set 1 is person, set 2 is the father of. Option A, Anton von Leeuwenhoek. And the matching number 1 is geometry. Option B, Hippocrates. And match number 2 is genetics. Option C, Gregor Mendel. Number 3, medicine. Option D, Usler. And 4 is virology. And you have option E, Maritmus Bajornik. And 5 is microbiology. And you have various options like A, B, C, D. So you have to select who is the father of which one. So now let's see the answer here. Anton von Leeuwenhoek is the father of microbiology, A5. Hippocrates is the father of medicine, so B3. Gregor Mendel is the father of genetics, C2. Euclid is the father of geometry, D1. Maritmus Bajornik is the father of virology, E4. So this is the match for a person and their contribution in the subject. Question number 14. Director General of World Health Organization at present is option A, Dr. Tedros, B, Antonio Guterres, option C, Claudia Hill, D, Henrietta H4. The WHO organization, World Health Organization Director General at present is Dr. Tedros from Ethiopia. Question number 15. Which of the following anti-tubercular drug is not hepatotoxic? Option A, isoniazid, B, rifampicin, C, pyrazinamide, D, streptomycin. The right answer is streptomycin is an anti-tubercular drug which is not hepatotoxic. Question number 16. Which of the following condition indicates portal hypertension? A, astraxis, B, confusion, C, orthostatic hypotension, D, hematemesis. The right answer is hematemesis represents portal hypertension. Question number 17. All are therapeutic communication techniques except option A, silence, B, feedback, C, acceptance, D, making observation. Except feedback, all other three are known as therapeutic communication techniques. Question number 18. Identify the symptoms of mental disorder which is not paired correctly. Phobia paired with feelings of dread. Mania, racing thoughts. Delirium, anhedonia. PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, nightmares. The symptom which is not paired correctly here is delirium and anhedonia. Anhedonia is the symptom of depression. Question number 19. Cleft lip occurs due to the failure of, this is embryology related question. Cleft lip occurs due to the failure of, option A, fusion of lateral nasal process with maxillary process. B, fusion of median nasal process with maxillary process. C, fusion of median and lateral nasal process. D, none of the above. The right answer is option B, fusion of median nasal process with maxillary process leads to prevention of cleft lip. So if this is not going to happen, cleft lip is going to occur in a baby. Question number 20. Which of the following coagulation factors is deficient in classical hemophilia? Factor 8, factor 9, 10 and 12. In classical hemophilia, the factor 8 is deficient or it is absent. Question number 21. The bone cells are connected with each other by option A, matrix, B, capillaries, C, Haversian canal, and D is canaliculi. Bone cells are connected with each other by canaliculi. Option D. Question number 22. Which of the following is a complication of splenectomy? Option A, cholecystitis, B, pancreatitis, C, appendicitis, D, gastritis. The complication of splenectomy, removal of spleen, is pancreatitis. 23. The length of the large intestine is option A, 2 feet, B, 5 feet, C, 3 feet, D, 4 feet. The length of large intestine is approximately 5 feet. 24. The following statement is true regarding auscultation of the gland. Option A, ronchi are characteristic of heart failure. B, crepitations are common in heart failure. C, ronchi are common over a pleural effusion. D, crepitations are characteristic of pleural effusion. Which of the following statement is true regarding auscultation of the gland? The right answer is crepitations are commonly one of the diagnostic findings when we auscultate in patient with heart failure. Question number 25. A client has paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea. Which of the following medication does a nurse anticipate will be prescribed by the physician? So in case of PND, paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, which medication can be prescribed by physician? Option A, lidocaine, xylocaine. B, bumetimide, bumet. C, propranolol, also known as interol. D, urokinase, also known as abokinase. The right answer is bumetimide, also known as bumide, can be prescribed by the physician in patient with paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea. Question number 26. For the patient with otitis media, nursing care is centered on reducing the severity or alleviating the problems. Option A, dizziness and decreased hearing. B, fever and tinnitus. C, pain and pressure in the ear. D, nausea and vomiting. The right answer is pain and pressure in the ear can be the right answer for this question. Question number 27. Blisters are mainly seen in option A, first degree burns, B, second degree burns, C, third degree burns, D, fourth degree burns. Blisters are commonly seen in second degree burns. Question number 28. What your urine color says about your health? Match the following. So you are having urine color and you have the inference. Dark yellow, syrup brown, blue green, pink reddish, orange. These are the urine colors and you have to match with the results. Like sign of severe dehydration. Second one is likely caused by food and diets. Three, occurs if you recently ate beets and blueberries. Fourth one is potential dehydration or liver bile duct disease. Fifth one is you are fine but need to be hydrated soon. So you have the options here. Now how you will match these things? Let's see the answer. Option C is correct. So here dark yellow indicates you are fine but need to hydrate soon. Option B, syrup brown indicates sign of severe dehydration. Blue or green, option C, indicates likely caused by food and dyes. Option D, pink and reddish, that is related to currently if you eat any beets or blueberries. Option E, orange color indicates that your potential dehydration and you are having liver or bile duct tissue problems. So this is how it is matched each other. 29. The non-modifiable risk factors for coronary heart disease except option A, high blood pressure, option B, age, C, sex, D, family history. Which is the modifiable risk factor according to this question? Is option A, high blood pressure. Question number 30. The 20-point program was launched by Government of India in the year option A, 1973, B, 1975, C, 1983, D, 1985. The 20-point program was launched in 1975 by Government of India. 31. Sentinel surveillance can be best explained by option A, establish natural history of disease. Option B, detect the total number of cases in a community. C, detect the missing hidden cases in the community. D, plan intervention. Sentinel surveillance can be best explained by, the right answer is detect the missing hidden cases in the community. Question number 32. Removal of entire lung is called as option A, pneumonectomy. B, segmental resection. C, wedge resection. D, lobectomy. Removal of entire lung is called as pneumonectomy. 33. Which of the following laboratory tests must be ordered before the patient started on isoniazid therapy? Option A, bleeding time and clotting time. B, liver function test. C, renal function test. D, serum electrolyte. Before starting isoniazid therapy, the test should be done for patient is liver function test. Question number 34. Administration of ready-made antibody creates option A, active acquired immunity. B, passive acquired immunity. C, active natural immunity. And D is passive natural immunity. Administration of ready-made antibody creates option B, passive acquired immunity. 35. Normal level of protein in CSF is option A, 5 to 12 milligram per deciliter. B, 15 to 45 milligram per deciliter. C, 45 to 80 milligram per deciliter. And D is 75 to 85 milligram per deciliter. So protein level normal in CSF is 15 to 45 milligram per deciliter. 36. Gonads develops from embryonic option A, ectoderm. B, endoderm. C, mesoderm. D, both mesoderm and endoderm. The right answer is mesoderm. Question number 37. A failure in lymphatic system to return body fluids adequately results in option A, swelling of hands and legs. B, swelling of face and hands. C, splenomegaly. D, swelling of tissues and edema. So failure in lymphatic system to return body fluids adequately results in splenomegaly, enlargement of spleen. Question number 38. Which color of light has the longest wavelength? Option A, violet, B, blue, C, red, D, green. The longest wavelength is red color. 39. A charge nurse observes that three staff members are arguing about their patient care assignments. Using the democratic style of leadership, the charge nurse should, option A, ignore the situation, B, facilitate a discussion of which staff member does what task, option B, tell the staff to do work out their differences on their own, option D, meet with each staff member at the end of the workday. The right answer is facilitate a discussion of which staff members does what tasks. Question number 40. When a patient who has emphysema reports increased respiratory effort, the nurse should instruct the patient to, option A, breathe through pursed lips, B, increase the humidity in the air, C, breathe into a paper bag, D, increase the oxygen flow rate. The right answer is option A, breathe through pursed lips. 41. To evaluate a patient for hypoxia, the physician is most likely to order which laboratory test? Option A, red blood count, B, sputum culture, C, total hemoglobin, D, arterial blood gas analysis. So the right answer is arterial blood gas analysis should be assessed when the patient is suspected for hypoxia. Question number 42. Which technique should the nurse plan to use when giving perineal care to an uncircumcised male client? Option A, clean the penis with NS solution. Option B, retract the foreskin and then clean the glans penis. Option C, wash the scrotum before the penis. Option D, wash the anal area at a separate time. The right answer is retract the foreskin and clean the glans penis. 43. The nurse is admitting a trauma patient to the emergency department. Which of the following should be the priority intervention? A, circulation, B, breathing, C, maintaining an open airway, D, disability. The right answer is maintaining an open airway is the priority nursing intervention. Question number 44. Drugs that cause expulsion of gas from the intestinal tract is option A, astringent, B, carminatives, C, cathartics, D, emetics. The right answer is carminatives is the drug which is used to remove the gas from the intestinal tract. 45. Match the following with their tonicity. You have the fluids dextrose 5, so NaCl, Y 0.9% of NaCl and Z 2.5% of dextrose, and tonicity you have hypotonic, hypertonic, isotonic. So how you will match this fluid with the tonicity? The right answer is X, dextrose 5% NaCl is a hypotonic solution. 0.9% of sodium chloride is isotonic solution. 2.5% of dextrose is a hypotonic solution. This is how it is matched. 46. Mercury is a liquid material used in thermometer because option A, it reflects the temperature reading. B, it fluctuates and fills easily after reading. Option C, expansion is uniform and easily visible. Option D, expansion is quick and is easily visible. Option D is expansion is quick and easy to difficult. The right answer is option C, expansion is uniform and is easily visible. 47. So name this device. It is an image based question. Name this instrument. The right answer is diathermy device used in orthopedic surgeries. Question number 48. As soon as the patient enters the post-anesthesia care unit, First priority assessment by the nurses, option A, urinary output, B, ECG monitoring, C, level of consciousness, D, airway patency and respiratory status. The right answer here is priority assessment when the patient comes from post-anesthesia unit is level of consciousness should be checked. 49. When being interviewed for a position as a registered professional nurse, the applicant is asked to identify an example of an intentional tort. What is the appropriate response? Option A, breach of duty. B, malpractice. C, false impressionment. And D is people with health problems. The right answer is false impressionment represents the intentional torts. Question number 50. When is the nasocomial infection occurs after admission? Option A, 48 hours to 28 days after discharge. B, 48 hours to 15 days after discharge. C, after discharge. D, before admission. The right answer is 48 hours to 28 days after discharge. Here we come to the end of part 1. Thanks for watching. Part 2 video is coming soon. Subscribe to SAT2 Carry Online Nursing channel if you have not yet subscribed.